lot of stuff going on here. I'm going to try and start at the front and work my way back. Mechanically speaking, the first thing that you'll probably notice is this arm right here. This is our intake mechanism, or before the match starts, we're held in frame perimeter by this piece of hook and loop tape. And then during the match, it will come down into this position here so that we're ready to intake game pieces, cargo, off of the floor. They come in over the bumper and into this, I guess you could call it a tray, right here. And this is just a piece of Lexan that we have that funnels our game pieces in towards our shooting mechanism at the back. Before we get there, we have two servos mounted on these upright posts that form a gate. And then that servo gate will allow us to hold the balls until we get into a shooting position. And then we can spin up our two flywheels that form the shooter. And when we're ready with that, we open up the servos, ball falls in, it comes into contact with this first flywheel, it's forced up the ramp and then into contact with the second, and then we can shoot, hopefully very consistently, into the high goal. And that's our entire kind of system for scoring points with the cargo. Additionally, we also have a climbing mechanism that comes in two main parts. First part is delivering the hook to the bar, and that's going to be this upright tube here, and that is really just a piece of PVC pipe nested inside of a 1x1 aluminum box tube. That is going to be pulled upwards by this wire right here, and that's attached to a winch at the base. So the winch will spool up the wire, forcing this tube up. It's difficult for me to do it, so that's why the winch does it. And then once the tube is up, we can detach the hook by hooking it onto the tube, or onto the bar that we climb on. And then this hook is attached to a rope and a further winch near the front of our robot, which is well, right here. And that's just gonna be our climbing mechanism. Otherwise, we have a standard kit of parts drivetrain. It's, I think, 32 inches long ways and 27 wide. So just a little bit under that 120 inch frame perimeter. And I think that's pretty much everything mechanically.
Hi, I'm Connor. I'm gonna walk you through our robot's electrical system. So, it's not shown here, but we have a battery mount. Make sure your battery is secure. It is part of the rules. If the battery falls out during a match, it could lead to issues from battery becoming disconnected to safety issues with the battery puncture. From there, this is where the battery plugs into, and we have our breaker switch. It's recommended for it to be easily accessible in case something goes wrong with the robot. It's very important to be able to turn it off in a timely manner. The battery cable and the wires leading out of the breaker into the power distribution panel are 6-gauge wire. This component in the center is called the power distribution panel, or PDP for short. This is where the larger components, larger electrical components get their power from. We see here this middle is partially full of fuses. Anything that plugs into these ports along the side has to have a fuse associated with it. Some important things to know, every motor that's used for your drivetrain has to be plugged into one of these ports on the lower half and into a 40 amp fuse. It's also recommended anything that does something such as lift the entire robot up is also into a 40 amp fuse. From there, these small pins right here power the smaller components such as the RoboRio and the voltage regulator module. Make sure you have a 10 amp fuse plugged into this slot and a 20 amp fuse plugged into this slot. The RoboRio gets its power by plugging it into the port labeled RoboRio, and the voltage regulator module gets its power plugged into the VRM spot shown here. If your robot needs a pneumatics control module, or PCM, that will also plug in to this section of ports right here. From there, going into the speed controllers, we're using CTRE Victor SPXs to control our motors. We have 4 drivetrain motors, so we need a total of 4 speed controllers. Every motor is required to have its own speed controller. You can't run motors in series or in parallel. Additionally, any motor that is used for the drivetrain has to use 12 gauge copper wire, which is what we're using here. We also have five Victors devoted to the other modules on the robot, such as our climbing mechanism, our elevator mechanism, and our intake, to name a few. Back to the voltage regulator module. This is used to power any smaller components that you might want or need, such as the radio. This plugs into the 12 volt 2 amp port on the voltage regulator module. You may see in another video, we have LED underlights that also plugs into 12 volt 2 amp. And finally, as required, we have our robot signal light, or RSL. This plugs into the RoboRio using this designated port. It is required in the rules to have it visible. You can have up to two. This is not a place where I would recommend it. This gives you information on whether the robot has power, whether it's disabled, or whether it's enabled. If the robot has no power, it'll be off. If it has power but is disabled, it'll be solid orange. And if it's on and enabled, it'll be flashing. So anytime you see a robot near you with a flashing RSL, that means keep clear.
We also have LEDs. That's important.